Okay. So let's review a couple things. Let's talk about, before we had break, we had end behaviors, right? So the end behavior was talking about what the graph did at the end. So it could look like that, or it could look like this. Or the end behavior could do this. Or it could do this. Okay? Okay. So these referred to raised to an even. So x to the second, x to the fourth, x to the sixth as the highest polynomial or highest coefficient. So if there's a 2, 4, 6, then what did that? If these values happen to be negative, so you had a negative out in front, or you had a negative number out in front of our largest exponent, that means the whole graph flips upside down. So the end behavior here as x approaches infinity, the function at x approaches infinity as far as that one goes. And the same thing as this. As x approaches negative infinity, meaning I'm going to the left, then the graph, the function at x, approaches infinity. This one here would talk about as x approaches infinity, then f at x approaches negative infinity, things like that. So both ways. These happen to do with if I had x to the first, third, fifth, or it was an odd number, okay, if it's raised to an even or odd, if the lead coefficient happens to be positive, that's going to happen. If it's negative, these are going to happen. So those were the end behaviors. And remember, we're not completely concerned with the end behavior of the graph. We are looking at, or we're not completely concerned with what's taking place in between the end behavior. We're just looking at what the graph is actually doing. Okay, what we're going to get to as far as this chapter goes is we're going to use something called synthetic division. We're also going to use long division. We're going to use factoring, a whole lot of different things, because you have a whole bunch of different situations where asymptotes take place, which can be horizontal, vertical, and end behavior asymptotes, and the end behavior asymptotes, also called an oblique asymptote. It's not hard. You just have to trust me. I can get you through it. I really can. But I think that as far as algebra goes, this is some of the coolest algebra because it has so much to do with it. What's kind of neat is end behavior asymptotes. Let's say you had some graph that, you know, it kind of looked like this. If you were able to figure out the end behavior asymptote, basically will be a line that goes right along it or right along it. Okay, so end behavior asymptote is the graph that you would approach towards the ends that you get to, but this is something we'll get to later this week. We also talked about zeros and multiplicity. And so you remember a zero is anywhere it crosses the x-axis or touches the x-axis. Okay, so if you had your xy axis, you know, you could have a graph that goes through just like that. These are zeros. Obviously, a zero would be there too. There are other things that could happen where it could bounce off of it. Okay, so those are different things. And that had to do with if it was raised, if you had a grouping of a binomial to an even exponent, means you have a bounce. If you have an odd exponent, it would go right through it. So if I had a graph, if I had able to factor a whole graph all the way down, and I had like x plus 2, x plus 2, x minus 3, x minus 3, and x minus 3, this right here is the same thing as saying x plus 2 as a quantity squared. So the multiplicity at x plus 2 has a 2 multiplicity because it happened twice. But x minus 3 can be written like this. And that means the multiplicity of x minus 3 is to the third power. So it's however many binomials take place. If this were graphed, this is going to have a bounce off the x-axis, and this is just going to go right through it. Okay? So if I had my xy-axis at negative 2, this is taking place, and at positive 3, this one's taking place. This is raised to the fifth power. My highest exponent, this is a fifth degree polynomial. If I had FOIL'd it out, my lead coefficient is going to be x to the fifth, which means my end behaviors are going to be doing this. That's what the end behaviors of the graph will do. At right here, that's going to create a bounce right here. It means this graph did this. It bounced, changed directions, and then this means that it's going to go right through it. So then it comes back through, and let's say you just connect to that. So that's what that graph would look like. The reason this bounces is because it's raised to the second power. If it's raised to the second, the fourth, the sixth, anything like that, it will bounce off the graph. If it's raised to the first, the third, the fifth, the seventh, anything like that, it will go right through it. It's really hard sometimes to see if you had a graph that it went right through. You might not know that you have the same root multiple times. But if you had a bounce, you know that you have that root at least twice. And that's kind of a key when you start factoring them down. Okay? So, end behavior talked about as my x goes to the right, to infinity, what does the graph itself do, the function at x do? And what does, as I go to the left, to negative infinity, what does my graph function at x also do? Those are the end behaviors. We talked about that 2 weeks ago. And then the zeros are, where is it taking place? Where does it cross the x-axis? Does it happen to bounce on the x-axis? If it bounces, it's that binomial, the x plus 2 or with x plus whatever, happens 2, 4, or 6 times, or you know, an even amount of times. If it goes right through it, it might happen only once, might happen 3 times, might happen 5 times, so on and so forth. When you go and look at these and you want to know what the degree of this whole function would be, you're looking, you're just counting. If you were to multiply all those together, it would come out to be x to the fifth plus a whole bunch of other stuff. Okay, so that's the degree. What would the lead coefficient be? Well, if I multiplied 5 x's together, x, 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 x together, it's to the fifth power, it's positive, so that's going to tell you end behavior. So this refers to this and this. You also get the degree. The multiplicity just means the number of times it's happening, and that's what we're going for. Okay? Feel okay? All right, if you have a graphing calculator, if you get it out, we're just going to run through a few examples. Why don't we do this? If I get through 1, 2, 3, 4 of these, that means you just walk out of here without homework. Deal?
Deal.
Okay. If I go get through these 4 problems, I want you walk out of here without homework. You do it? Okay, if I only get through 2 of them, that means you have 2 problems for homework. If I get through 3, you have 1 problem for homework. If I get through all 4, you're good to go. So copy this down, have your calculators out. No, you can just watch, it's being recorded, so you can always refer back to it if you need to. 1990. percent. 2000.
Gordon.
You guys have the power test? All
right.
You. You. As soon as I'm proud of you, I'm testing.
Don't you have to do it?
Okay. So, take a look. We have some data. This is what this problem says. It says foreign-born population. It says the percentage of the United States population that is foreign-born has increased in recent years as the table below. Okay. Problem one says use a graphing calculator to fit cubic quartic functions to the data, let X represent the number of years since 1990, okay? Or 1900, excuse me. Use the functions to estimate the percentage. Okay, so here's a few things that we're going to think about. When we plug data in, what tells us if our data has a good equation to it? What thing on our calculator tells us? What? R squared. And so what we're looking at on all of these is we want to refer to the R-squared value to verify if that R-squared value is the best fit for our data. So if we did a linear, remember linear is going to give you both R and R-squared. Always refer to the R-squared. Okay? We're going to also look at the quadratic regression. We're going to look at the cubic regression. And we're also going to look at the quartic regression. Okay? So all of those are going to say how we're going to do this. So I'm going to go through using the graphing calculator, plug it in. You got to make sure your R squared value is on in order for this to work. So I'm going to pull our calculator over here. When you go into your calculator, clear all of your items out that you don't need there under Y equals. Is my plot on just by looking at that? What does it say up here? No, one of them has to be highlighted. So I can go to stat. I can edit. I'm going to clear my data that's already there. So I'm going to go up to the top, hit clear, then down arrow. And then over to list one, I'm going to hit clear and then down arrow. And I'm going to plug my data in. So I'm going to start with 1900. It's your choice if you want to start with 0, go 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60 all the way. Or if you want to plug in the value. So I'm just going to plug in 1900. Oops. 1900, 1910, 1920, 1930, 1940, 1950, 1960, 1970, 1980, 1990. 2004. Okay, if I arrow over, I can go ahead and keep it as percentages. So I realize L2 would be percentages, so I have 13.6%. Oops, 13.6. 14.7. 13.2. 11.6, 8.8, 6.9, 5.4, 11.7. Okay? Once you plug your data in, what allows you to see your data plotted on the calculator screen? Does it just graph? If I hit just graph, zoom stat is going to be the one I want to hit. So I'm going to hit zoom. Oh, but what did I need to turn on? Stat plot. So I'm going to go Y equals. I'm going to turn my first stat plot on. So it's blinking on the on. I'm going to hit enter. I want it to be data, L1, L2, and boxes. Cool. From there, once it's turned on, I'm going to hit zoom. And I'm going to go to Zoom Stat. And Zoom Stat's going to allow us to see what our data looks like. So what do you guys think? What kind of equation? Does it look like a linear equation? No? Does it look like a quadratic? Kind of maybe, but you have this one little tail. So let's do a few things. I know my R squared value is on, so I'm going to go stat, calculate, and I'm going to find the linear regression first. So the linear regression is number 4, and let's just see what takes place with number 4. R squared value, 0.27, 27%, good on a test? No, that's not going to work. So let's go back in. We're going to go stat, we're going to calculate, and let's calculate the quadratic regression, which is number 5. And you could hit L1, L2. I'm just going quick. I have an R squared value of 0.786. So 78.6, an okay grade? It's an okay grade, but I want it closer to 100%. So then I'm going to go back in. I'm going to hit stat, calculate. And I want to hit the cubic regression, number 6. Hit enter. The cubic regression, R squared is at 97%. Does that sound good? So my equation, the whole thing's given. Okay? Now, it's your choice if you want to take these all the way out. What does e to the negative 5 mean? Scientific. So this right here, it actually would be, our a value would be 0.000053 x to the third minus 0.309 x to the second plus 599.13x plus, oops, minus 386,679.16. So my whole equation, my A value, my B value, my C value, my D value, okay? We can go ahead and graph that. Oh, I'm starting to squeak. Puberty's hitting in. I squeaked in my voice. All right, so I'm going to go y equals. Where's my graph stored?
Bars.
Bars. What's next? Statistics. What's next? Over to EQ of our equation. Hit enter. It's going to plot my whole graph there. Hopefully this whole thing worked. It's not going to work. I don't know why this calculator is goofy. Like,
doesn't work.
I don't know what the deal is. Did you work on yours? Tell me what the equation is on yours. 0.0005. X raised to the third. Quit. And then minus 0.309 minus 0.309 x squared. Last value. What's my last value? 658,000, something like that?
150
is
minus
or plus?
In the summer, one of them would always be gone. And then the
yeah, we'll see how close we are.
Yeah.
Ah, it didn't show up.
Awesome. There was a little Mickey just loves to have intellectual
conversations. Darn it, my calculator's being goofy. So, anyhow, if you had that, if you had that x squared value, it should plug right in here. You know, drawing up and then up. So it draws nicely here. So that's basically, ooh, squeak again. That's basically what my graph should look like, okay? If I do that, could I predict what later years would be?
Yeah.
What was it called if I predict outside of my data?
Extrapolate.
Extrapolate, good. If I plot inside my data, what's it called?
Interpolate.
Okay? So those are things you can definitely do. So when you're working these problems on the assignment, you got to make sure, I think we're going to get done with almost all of them. You got to make sure your R squared value is as high as it can get. Okay? You want it as close to 1.00 as possible in order to do it. Can we work another problem?
Yep.
We good? Or do you guys just want to work them?
No.
No, dude, don't do that. All right. Our next question talks about United States farm acreage. It says the number of farms has decreased in the United States. The average size of the remaining farms has grown larger, as shown in the following table. Okay? Yo! I said you're over there getting a burrito at that good old burrito joint. I love that place. Whether you wear a word, I don't know. It might be a market. Tardy. Hey, congratulations, by the way, bub. It's a good thing you beat that Pop Warner team called Chaparral. When I get done recording, you might be tell you a story about him. His name is Zack Snyder.
Makes sense.
Snyder. What happened? Someone not doing well? And me? Did I do something wrong again?
I'm kidding.
Yeah, go for it. List one, list two, here you go. 2004. All right, go ahead and plot that into your calculator under list one, list two. I'm sorry. I'm trying. There you go. I'm pretty sure you'll be able to walk on through. And I kind of don't want to do anymore. I think you guys can do the last two. All right. So, what did I do? So, your assignment is page 268. Let's have you do 79 and 80. Two whole problems to work on. Okay? So if it's cubic to the third, quartic to the fourth, it's called quintic if it goes to the fifth. And then there's all these other Latin roots to it. So that's all I got for you.